Welcome to the video presentation on possible hazards and accidents while working on power distribution network. These hazards may result in near miss, incidents or accidents. Note that accidents always result in injury or loss of property or life. We will see the injuries that occur in case of accidents. We will also learn how to give first aid. The first case is injury due to which there is bleeding internally or externally. Let us understand how to control bleeding. I will tell you what you should do in case of internal bleeding. Let us assume the victim is bleeding in the stomach. In this case, you need to use cold compression technique. Cover and hold it on the area where the patient says there is pain. Then, while compressing, support the patient and bring him to a half-sitting position. This helps in reducing the bleeding and the patient starts feeling better. We have to keep reassuring the patient continuously so that he does not panic. Sometimes, we see that the patient and his family members and people around the victim are very scared. In such a case, keep reassuring the patient and the family members so that the patient relaxes. We should immediately call the ambulance so that the patient can be given immediate medical care. If possible, the patient should be asked to fold his legs like this so that bleeding reduces. If we can give at least this much first aid before medical aid arrives, the patient's chances of survival increase by 50%. Let me now tell you what happens due to heavy bleeding. We usually see that when someone hurts the fingers and they are bleeding, they keep moving their hand continuously to get some relief from pain. However, this is not correct. If the hand is rested without moving, we notice that bleeding reduces. The next thing we can do is to elevate the injured limb above the heart level. After elevating the hand, we have to give a slight pressure with fingers or palm and ask the patient to keep the pressure. If this is not done and the patient starts moving the hand, the bleeding will increase. Take a handkerchief and cover the wound. Keep the hand elevated above the heart level. When we do not have anything else to reduce the bleeding, we need to keep the wound covered and elevated. This will help the patient to relax. We have to keep reassuring the patient that he will be all right and that he will soon be taken to the hospital or his home. This will help the patient to relax and recover faster. Now, let us know what to do when people suffer injuries with broken bones. Let us now learn what to do if a person breaks a bone. First, the broken limb should not be moved at all. Assume that this person has broken his leg bone. Do not touch or move the leg. If the injured person is in a public place, take the help of the people. If we are in an institute, we can take cardboard and create a splint to support the limb. If that is not available, take a 12-inch scale to create a splint. If that is also not available and we are in a public place, we can use any stick or the stick of a policeman to support the broken leg. If nothing is available, then nothing should be done and the limb should not be touched. You can move the healthy or unbroken limb and bring it closer to the broken limb. There are several areas of the body from where bandage can be passed. It can be under the waist, under the neck, under the knee and under the ankle. We can tie a bandage from below these areas. If we do not have any bandage, we can use either shoelaces or the patient's belt, depending on what is available. Suppose we have bandage, we should use the body joints to tie it above and below those joints. Here, I have taken the bandage from below the ankles and tied the ankles together. Do not pressure on the broken limb, but put pressure on the unbroken ankle portion. Here, we have tied the bandage to stop the movement of the broken limb. If another bandage is tied, it should be used to tie around the joints. We should always ensure that the pressure is on the unbroken side of leg, and never tie on the broken limb. Tying a bandage in this way will cause pain to the patient. If the patient is conscious, reassure him that he is safe so that he is able to relax. We have tied the bandage below the joints. We will tie one more bandage above the broken limb. If we are able to do this, we have saved the patient by 80%. After he reaches the hospital, he will be able to recover quickly. Let us now learn what to do when a person suffers injuries by fire. Today, I will tell you what you should do if a person is injured by fire. Always remember that when treating a patient who suffered burn injuries, we should wash and dry our hands or use rubber gloves. This is because patients with burn injuries are more prone to infections. In case of minor burns, make the patient sit and wash the burn injury under running water. In case there is no running water available, take stored water and immerse the burned area in the water. You can change the water after 10 minutes. In case water is not available, you can use ice. Ice must be wrapped in a cloth and used as a compress. If a person has burnt his hand, do not touch it at all. If the patient is scared, reassure the patient and keep talking to him, asking him questions about himself and his family, so that his attention is diverted from pain and he is able to relax. We should wash the burn area with cool water. We have to cool down the burnt area immediately so that the patient starts feeling better. Sometimes people apply things like toothpaste or other creams on the burn injury. This should never be done. After washing, cover the burn with a clean cloth and take the patient to a hospital. What has to be done when a person is injured with electric shock? Let us know how you should do in this situation. We are associated with the electricity department. Therefore, we see several electrocution cases when working on a line or grid station. Consumers can also face such accidents at home. Let us learn to provide first aid in case of electrocution. First, we need to understand that electrocution is also an injury. The severity might be very high because electricity travels through the body into the earth. When this happens, electricity ruptures the body tissue. This leads to internal bleeding, which leads to shock. In case of electric shock, the most important treatment should be treatment for shock. Other first aid treatments remain the same. If a person is bleeding, suitable first aid must be provided. In case of fracture, suitable aid must be given. In case of breathing problem or if heartbeat has stopped, CPR should be given. The most important thing to be done for electric shock is to switch off the source of electricity. Use a bad conductor like a stick or cloth. Switch off the power source first. Under no condition should you touch a live person in panic with your bare hands. The difference between normal injuries and electric shock is that electric shock is a higher level of injury. The patient should be taken to a doctor immediately for medical attention. There is no need to panic. Take care of the patient and ensure that the patient gets treatment immediately. Let us learn the first aid to be given when a person's arm is injured. If there is an injury on the upper arm, we need to provide support to that part. We may not carry bandage with us always. We need to improvise with the available items to provide support to the arm. First, remove the shirt button and place the arm closer to the body. This ensures that there is support to the arm. Also, the arm will not be hanging down. If the broken arm is hanging down, there is more pressure and pain for the patient. If we give support to the arm, it provides relief to the patient. Now, let us learn what you should do when a person's head is bleeding. In case a person has a head injury and the patient is bleeding, the patient will be scared. First, assure the patient that he will be fine. Take a handkerchief and use it to cover the wound and provide direct pressure on the wound. This will help in controlling the bleeding. Cover the wound and reassure the patient. If you feel that bleeding is very heavy, you can take another cloth and use it to cover the wound further. We should not remove the first bandage. We should add a new bandage on top of the existing one. This will help to stop the bleeding and we can make the patient sit comfortably. Finally, let us know what to do when a person's shoulder is injured. If a person suffers a shoulder injury, to avoid simple fracture from becoming complex, we need to stop the movement of the shoulder. In this situation, the patient experiences a lot of pain. We should give support in the armpit to avoid movement of the shoulder. Generally, we do not see plaster being used on the face and chest. Plaster is used only on legs or hands. We should use a bandage or belt or anything suitable to the arm around the chest to avoid movement of the part. This will provide support to the entire shoulder. If we can do this much in case of collarbone fractures, we would be providing great relief to the patient. You have seen what type of first aid should be provided to patients under different circumstances.